Hello and good day to all the horror fans out there on YouTube. I've always had a soft spot in my heart for the Amityville franchise. Well, before indie filmmakers started to make no-budget movies with the Amityville name attached to them. I believe the original Amityville Horror is one of the best haunted house movies of all time. The second one is one of the most insane movies of all time, and there are plenty of fun stuff to be found in the others that followed, especially in the trilogy of cursed item movies that came out during the first half of the 1990s. Today I'm reviewing the last one out of that trilogy, which started with a haunted clock and a haunted mirror, and I'm sure you can guess what's haunted in this one by its title alone. I am Torstein from CinemaTerror, and this is Amityville Dollhouse. Dollhouse starts out in the same way that the majority of these films do. A family moves into a new house and weird supernatural shit starts to happen. In this case, the family is made up of Bill and Claire, and their three children that they both have from previous relationships. Bill has spent the last year constructing their dream house, but he made one small mistake. The house was built around the remains of a previous house that burned down, leaving only a fireplace that Bill felt would be a good center to build his new home around. While trying to bond the new family together, Bill comes across a dollhouse that looks suspiciously like the original Amityville house. Without knowing better, he decides that this creepy thing should be given to his young daughter Jessica as a birthday present. Even though she becomes sick after playing with it for only a short moment, and surreal things start to happen with the family, they do not realize the danger they are in. This dollhouse does not only look like the original Amityville house, but also has some connection with it, as there are demons residing within it. Can the family make it out of this home intact, or are they doomed to find a final fate in the dollhouse of Amityville? No. So Dollhouse is the 8th entry into the original Amityville series, and you can tell that the higher-ups didn't really care all about the franchise at this point. That does sort of work in favor for the movie, as screenwriter Joshua Michael Stern could go full on crazy with this script. You gotta give him credit though, as how the hell are you supposed to take the premise of a haunted dollhouse seriously? Thankfully he didn't, and the result becomes a movie that cares more about entertaining you than provide a logical story. So yeah, don't expect any explanation of how this dollhouse came to be, or why demons from Amityville lives in it, or how it came into the possession of this family. It just doesn't matter. Instead, you should rather stay with it for the fun stuff that they come up with. There is a zombie dad with quirky humor, there's a weird incest thing introduced, and some cool looking demon costumes at the end, which in fact was leftovers from different productions that never came to light. The characters in Dollhouse might not be the most clever ones, but their family dynamic are handled decently. I don't think anyone necessarily did a bad job in this, it's just that the material that they are given didn't have much room to show off strong and impressive performances. I do want to mention that Jarrett Lennon plays a young kid in this, and I will always remember him from the 1991 film Servants of Twilight. He looked so fragile and sickly in both of these movies, and that did give him a uniqueness to make him stand out. I should also mention Clayton Murray, who plays the zombie dad. He was great in this, and he had some very funny lines that at least made me laugh several times. This character alone could have been the backbone for an entire movie, and I would have been happy. If they ditched the whole Amityville thing, they could have turned this into a house sequel, instead by giving the zombie dad more screen time, and I would have been all for it.
They're coming for you, Bill. Gonna eat your soul.
Dollhouse was the first and only film directed by Steve White, who has spent most of his career as a producer. He actually started out on another Amityville film, the 1989 made for TV Amityville Horror The Evil Escapes, and he was also on board for both A New Generation and It's About Time before taking the director's chair himself on this one. Amityville Dollhouse might not be a good movie, but it is a fun movie for the right viewer. If you already seen the first two in the Cursed Items trilogy, the Haunted Clock one in Amityville 1992, It's About Time, and the Haunted Mirror in Amityville A New Generation, and enjoy those, then this should be a no-brainer. Dollhouse is better than A New Generation, and nearly on par with It's About Time, so that should tell you what to expect from this one. I will probably keep on revisiting all three of these films several more times in the future, as they are a comfort movie for me, easy to watch and easy to enjoy. And that's why I'm giving Amityville Dollhouse the good score of 3 out of 5. Have you seen Amityville Dollhouse? Or how about A New Generation or It's About Time? What do you think of any of these, and would you want me to do a video review of any of the two others? And feel free to share your thoughts on the other Amityville movies as well in the comment section below. I do have videos up for both the poor Amityville The Awakening and the awful The Amityville Terror, so if you can't get enough of this evil house, or at least the name of it, then feel free to check those out. I hope you enjoyed this video of Amityville Dollhouse. If you did, then please do leave a like and or a comment, as that does help out. And as always, I hope to see you return again for more horror-related content here on CinemaTerror. Thank you.